In March of this year, the FDA announced that they were considering setting a standard for a maximum nicotine level in cigarettes to make them minimally addictive or non-addictive. JAMA this week is publishing a clinical trial comparing two different approaches the FDA is considering for implementing reduced nicotine cigarettes. The first approach reduces nicotine levels in cigarettes immediately, which might cause a significant number of smokers to experience withdrawal symptoms and seek nicotine from other sources. The second reduces nicotine levels gradually, which might result in prolonged exposure to smoke toxicants, compensatory smoking during the early stages of nicotine reduction, and similar or even lower smoking cessation rates. The objective of this study was to compare the two approaches to assess differences in biomarkers of smoke exposure. Researchers conducted a randomized trial at 10 sites across the U.S. The participants were volunteers who were daily smokers with no intention to quit within 30 days. They had a mean age of 45 years. 701 were men and 549 were women. After 2 weeks of baseline smoking, the 1,250 participants were randomized to three groups. The first group smoked lower nicotine cigarettes for 20 weeks, where the nicotine was immediately reduced from the standard 15.5 milligrams to 0.4 milligrams per gram of tobacco. The second group also smoked lower nicotine cigarettes for 20 weeks, but the nicotine was gradually reduced every 4 weeks over the trial period from 15.5 milligrams to 0.4 milligrams per gram of tobacco. The third, or maintenance group, continued smoking standard cigarettes with 15.5 milligrams of nicotine per gram of tobacco. The primary outcome was between-group differences in biomarkers of smoke exposure over the 20 weeks of intervention. The biomarkers were breath carbon monoxide, urine phenanthrene tetraol, an indicator of exposure to polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, and 3-HPMA, a volatile organic compound metabolite. Secondary outcomes included smoking behaviors like cigarettes smoked per day, number of cigarette-free days, and survey measures of nicotine dependence. Let's review the results. 958 of the 1,250 participants completed the trial. Lower levels of exposure were observed for all three biomarkers in the immediate nicotine reduction group compared with the gradual nicotine reduction group. Lower levels of exposure were also observed in the immediate nicotine reduction group compared with the control group for all three biomarkers. But no statistically significant differences were observed between the gradual reduction group and the control group for any of the biomarkers. In terms of the secondary outcomes, participants in the immediate nicotine reduction group had fewer total cigarettes per day, a higher mean number of cigarette-free days, and lower measures of nicotine dependence compared with those in the gradual nicotine reduction group. The authors conclude that immediate reduction in nicotine content of cigarettes provided the greatest reduction in biomarkers of smoke exposure over time and a reduction of cigarette consumption. However, they also note that the immediate reduction in nicotine caused greater withdrawal symptoms, greater use of non-study cigarettes, and higher dropout rates. One last thing. Our open access journal, JAMA Network Open, recently published a study looking at how smoking reduced nicotine cigarettes affects smoking behaviors. The results of that trial also demonstrated that replacing standard cigarettes with reduced nicotine cigarettes did not lead to an increase in smoking or exposure to the toxic components of cigarette smoke. The link to that study is in the description below.